Hey everyone, Dustin here, back with another quick array method guide. This time we'll be covering filter. It's pretty simple, and as the name suggests, we can use this method to filter out array elements. Check the description or teacher's notes below for extra resources, as well as a related blog article if reading is more your thing. If you're ready, let's write some code. All I have is an empty project opened in VS Code. I'll create an app.js and run this file with Node. If you're unfamiliar with Node or don't have it installed, you can run all of the following code in your browser's console if you'd like to follow along. I'll quickly go over how this method works with a simple demonstration, and then I'll set up a bit more of a complex example and have you figure it out. So let's get started. Let's create a variable called numbers and set it equal to an array with some numbers. We can use 10, 20, 30, 40, and 50. Let's say you wanted to get all numbers from this array that are greater than 22. This is how we can do it. Let's create a new variable named higher than 22, and we'll set it equal to our numbers array with the filter method. Inside this filter method, we'll write num with an arrow function, and then num followed by the greater than operator, and then 22. Now let's console.log this higher than 22 variable. You can see we get back an array with 30, 40, and 50 inside. So let's break down this code and figure out what we just wrote. We have our numbers array and then the filter method. Inside the method, you see num with an arrow function and then num, the greater than operator, and then 22. But where did this num word come from? Well, this is the element parameter that we have access to with the filter method. This is a variable that holds the reference to the current array element being processed. Filter basically loops through your array and performs the logic or function that you provide. Each time through this loop, the value of the current element being processed will be referenced by this num variable. You can name this anything you'd like, but it's best to be descriptive. So the first time through the array, num holds the value of the first array item, which in this case is 10. It runs the logic we've written to test if num, or 10, is greater than 22, and it's not. So it then proceeds to the next array item, 20. 20 is also not greater than 22, so it moves to the next array item again. 30 is greater than 22, so it adds it to a new array and stores it into our variable that we set up, higher than 22. This process continues until there's no more items in our array to loop over. The ending result is a new array with only the items that were a result of our function. So higher than 22 holds an array with the numbers 30, 40, and 50, excluding 10 and 20. Pretty simple. So, does filter work with strings? You bet. Let's take a look at how we can filter array elements with strings. We have here an array named students. Inside of our array, we have an object for each student containing a name, age, and eye color property. We'll want to filter out all students with brown eyes. So let's give this a try. I'll create a variable named brown-eyed students and set it equal to our students array with the filter method. Inside the filter method, I'll write student, an arrow function, and then student.iColor. We're writing .iColor because the element parameter that we are using, which is set to student, holds a reference to the array element, which is the entire object. So we'll need to get the iColor property from this object. Then we'll write is strictly equal to the string of brown. We'll console.log our new brown-eyed students variable, and we'll see that we get back an object for George and Beth since both have the eye color of brown. Pretty neat. Now I want to give you a challenge. See if you can create a new variable named under 30 and have it equal to all the students that are under the age of 30. Pause the video now and give it a shot. Hey, so were you able to figure it out? If so, awesome. If not, that's totally okay. Let's write the solution together. The first step would be to set up a new variable and name it under 30. We'll set it equal to our students array, .filter, and inside this .filter method, we'll write student, with an arrow function and then student.age. The less than operator, and then 30. I'll console.log our new under 30 variable. And sweet, we get back all the students that are under the age of 30, which are Kelly and George. That about wraps it up for this array method. I use this method a ton in my projects, and I think you will too. Way too often, you'll need to filter data based on certain conditions, and this is the best way to do it. I hope this guide helped, and I'll see you in the next one. Until then, have fun and happy coding.